What is up, everybody? GoJita851 finally back with a new box day after months of waiting for figures to arrive. And boy, fun stories all around. You know, the next couple of videos with how things have been going with you know, things coming in and you know, the channel and what I've been doing. So first off, we have the X Plus Godzilla 2021 25cm from the film Godzilla vs. Kong. First off, here's the box. Now, you got your standard box. It's a lot larger than a normal 25cm box, but however, they've switched over to this, which I like. And yeah, because even though it is 25cm, it is much taller than your normal. And I'll show a description of it later towards another 25cm Godzilla. So the box shows off Godzilla very well here, you know, from Godzilla vs. Kong 2021, looking awesome. But the main thing I really like about this box is over on the back with legal jargon, it has this really cool Godzilla vs. Kong, you know, symbol on here. Really cool. So, alright, enough of that. So, I got this figure from Hobby Search over in Japan. They were having a sale, quite the sale. I'm not sure if the sale is still going on at the time of this recording. However, I said to myself, there's no way that they'd be selling this figure on, you know, sale, because it wasn't announced too long ago, and it's only really hit, you know, I hit the shelves, but it's really hit the market not too long, probably about a month ago, this hit the market. So when I saw that Hobby Search was having a sale, I thought, there's no way it was. And I got this thing for very cheap, you know, so I highly recommend it. If they're still having that sale, you know, if things are, you know, going even better, I recommend going over to Hobby Search and picking up one of these if you don't have it pre-ordered through another means, which that's a funny story to get to at a future time. Anyway, looking at this Godzilla and hearing what people thought about it, you know, for the past couple of weeks, people just getting to collector's hands, and this thing has run the gambit of love and dislike. A lot of people really have mixed feelings on this. The Rick feature, when it was announced about late August, early September, I think, 2021, and it has the blue dorsal plates, you know, light-ups, and in the mouth as well. Those look really cool, however, like a lot of things nowadays, you know, I don't really have the funds, you know, where I wanted them or needed them. So I didn't go for the Rick. With that said, let's talk about the figure. The figure, I think, who am I kidding? This thing's awesome, okay? Just look at this. This thing is awesome. You know, I love this stance he has. More of a dynamic pose than the 2019 Godzilla. It's more of a standard, almost walking stance. And that figure is awesome. I'm not dogging that at all. I love the 2019 X Plus Godzilla. This one is, in my opinion, just as good, okay? The stance is awesome. Just looking at it. The sculpt is also very awesome. All the scales and all the little muscles and all that stuff on him is very well done. Spartanly done. This thing looks like so many crosses between different animals. I see a little bit of alligator in here. I see a bit of, you know, Komodo dragon in here. I see a bunch of different reptilian animals mixed into this, and it looks amazing. The dorsal plates look amazing. The scales, the face, that roaring face, the tiny teeth, the little beady eyes. Godzilla has beady eyes. This Godzilla has beady eyes. It is not a problem for me. Okay, I think it's right out of the movie. Looks amazing. I absolutely love this Godzilla, and I absolutely love this figure. So, that's about detail and all the stuff I usually talk about, you know. Get to the really nitty-gritty of this. Right off the bat, you got the teeth. Very small, very pointy, and looks awesome. All individually sculpted. Paint job is done very well. A couple of teeth are a little crooked on the right side, but, you know, that's all right. The left side, they're all straight down, looking awesome. Nice pink and red on the inside of the mouth, looking awesome. The roof of the mouth is also very well detailed and sculpted in there. Very awesome, just like it is in the film. Okay, Moving on to the face, that roaring, scowling look as he's really mad. Like he wants to really fight Kong, or he sees Mechagodzilla. He really wants to fight Mechagodzilla. He's just really fierce and looking like a monster. Just awesome. A king of the monsters, you say. And just looking awesome. Okay. Scales going down the neck into the gills. All right, that's another thing I really like about this Godzilla. Very pronounced gills he has around the neck. Just looks awesome. It's always implied that Godzilla has gills in the other films, you know, the Showa, the Eisei, stuff like that. But here they're really showing it off. I just think it gives this Godzilla more character. Allows him to stand on his own apart from other Godzilla incarnations. Looking awesome. Moving on to the chest and the arms. He's got that roaring stance, you know, the arms are cocked up a little bit, like he's getting ready to, like, take in a deep breath, about ready to breathe fire, or he's in the process of roaring, just looking awesome. The chest has that armored piercing, that armored plating looking look to it, you know, very strong undercarriage, looking awesome. And it's actually, some of the scales actually kind of remind me of the, you know, the Showa and the Heisei Godzilla a little bit as well. It's almost like two different layers of scales, you know. You got the thicker parts and then you got the softer parts as well. Just looking awesome. Moving on to the waist and the legs. So Godzilla is actually cocked in a different position like he normally is in other X Plus figures. A more dynamic pose. Everything kind of curls off to his right. And he's almost like in a big turning motion. So the left leg is back where the right leg is forward a little bit. The feet are nice and flush on the ground, you know, toes are spread out, looking awesome. The scales looking awesome as well. There's kind of a little bit of a seam right here around where the knee is for the upper part of the leg, the calf, I guess that's called. I suck at anatomy, okay? So it's looking awesome, okay? The undercarriage of the legs and the belly, you know, continue. Well, the undercarriage of the belly carries on into the legs as well. It's almost like a giant suit of armor and allows him to move around. It's like you got the protective layers on the top, where the under part is more exposed, so you can have more freedom and mobility. Looking awesome. The feet, I love how they redesigned the feet from the 2014. You know, where he had very, you know, stubby feet in that film, and I just did not really care for that. But now they've really flattened out and looks really awesome. Love them. Love them. Moving on to the tail. Curls off to his right. And, you know, for that, you know, dynamic pose, just looking awesome. It's all of it. Now, the tail is actually, you know, that's a bit of discussion, you know. In the 2014 film, it actually came off to more of a point. Very thin lizard tail. You know, if you like got whipped with that thing would hurt. Well, they actually shortened his tail a bit for the 2019 and 2021 film and actually rounded it off. So it almost looks like an alligator tail, you know, allows him to, you know, swim through the ocean better. Because that's what he does. He like curls together, almost like an iguana, you know, swimming through the ocean. Just looking awesome. You know, I love that battle sequence. He had Kong out in the sea. Awesome stuff. Lastly, let's look on at the dorsal plates. Again, they look awesome. Paint job done very well. The sculpting also done very well. They all stand apart from each other. They're not like that uniform look to them, you know, and I always did like it that they changed it for the future films, because in 2014, they all were kind of triangles on his back. I did not like that. But they changed it for the future films, so it gives him flavor moving forward. So, you know, I accept all of it, so good stuff. And actually, they kind of keep that a little bit towards the bottom where the tail is. You know, they're a little more triangular, you know, around where the tail, the base, you know, in the middle and stuff like that. So, good stuff. Good stuff. Okay, so final thoughts of the X Plus 25 centimeter Godzilla 2021. This is standard, and I absolutely love it. Shocker, right? Anyway, awesome figure. I absolutely recommend it. Now, let's do some size comparisons, you know, to give them a little more scale and to show them off a little more with his other parts. And here he is with the 25-centimeter Godzilla 1984. And actually, you can see that this is almost the same size as a normal 25 centimeter. You know, he's got a little more girth and a little more mass compared, but as far as height-wise, he's not really that much taller than the 84 figure. And just looking awesome together, and, you know, it does look more akin to the 25-centimeter than the 2019 one was, but we'll get to that in just a little bit. All right, let's look at another one. All right, this one's better. We got Godzilla 2021 with the 75 Mechagodzilla 2. And I'm kind of holding Mechagodzilla up a little bit because when I let him go, he kind of dips back a little bit. But when he's flat on his feet, they're about the same height the way how I'm looking at it. You know, these things do look very good together. Now, yeah, of course, it's not the right year. They're not really supposed to be the same size, whatever. They still look really good together like this. So, I think a 2021 Mechagodzilla would do great in this line. But these two look good. If you want to take some past meets the future, you know, kind of thing. Looking awesome. All right, let's move on to the next one. And here he is with the 25-centimeter Final Goji from the film Godzilla Final Wars. Now, this Godzilla is more roaring upward to be with the Kaiser Ghidorah that came out around the same time as this. So, it might be a little deceiving that he's taller than this Godzilla. But however, use your imagination a little bit. I'm using it a little bit right now. And you imagine the head downward, you know, mouth closed. He would actually be taller than this Godzilla as well. So, I take back what I said earlier. This thing would pretty much perfectly fit in with the other 25-centimeter Godzilla figures. You know, comparing them with this Godzilla. All right, let's look at one more 25-centimeter before we get to the main event. And, yeah. And here he is with the Godzilla 67 25-centimeter, one of my favorite suits of Godzilla, one of my favorite incarnations of Godzilla, one of the first Godzilla films I saw as a lad, and, yeah, he's quite taller than the 67 Godzilla. So, this Godzilla also, the head is actually bent down a little bit, so he's kind of looking down, say, at, like, Minya or something. So if his head was up a little higher, you know, probably about right here. So they'd be like eye to eye with each other as well. So, yeah. I'd say these guys would go together as 25 Sam. Now, time for the main event. The main event. We've got Godzilla 2021 mixed off with Little Minya. I'm just kidding. Here is Godzilla 2019 compared to 2021. And yes, you can clearly see that the 2019 is much, much larger than the 2021, okay? Now, I guess you can say because he's more evenly spread out. You know, he starts at the nose and then comes out where the 2021 is actually more in his turn and his stance. However, if you look at him like this, face on, you can see that this Godzilla has a lot more going on, you know, than this one. He's got a lot more law, more mass. He's got more. The stance does make him look a lot larger as well. So they're almost the same, you know, height and weight wise, I'd say, for figures. However, I'd say the 2019 just beats him out, especially the tail. That tail is much longer as well. So both awesome figures. However, which one is better, the 2019? I'm not going to lie, the 2019 is a better figure. However, this 2021 does look amazing as well. All right, let's wrap this up. And in the end, the Godzilla 2021 25-centimeter is amazing. Okay, I love the stance. I love the paint job. I love the sculpt. This thing is... I need a turntable for... doing this. It's kind of goofy, me turning up my hands. Anyway, this thing is awesome. Highly recommend it. You know, this thing is, I have a nice spot picked out for it. The dynamic pose might cause a little bit of an annoyance, but I think it's going to be worth it. And especially since they announced the X-Plus Mechagodzilla King Ghidorah 2019 So that'd be awesome to see these two up against each other, and especially the 2019 with Gear. But anyway, these would look awesome as well, because, you know, because he's more of an attack pose. Now, this does have a companion piece coming later this year in King Kong. I'm sorry, Kong. And that one I was able to get the Rick. So I can't wait to put those two together. So till next time, this is Gojin851 saying I'm finally back. I was off for a bit, but more reviews to come. Till next time. Y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. We're over 1,000 subs. I love you guys so much for that. Thank you very much. But until next time, please like, comment, share, subscribe, and see y'all later.